The High Court Civil Division Judge Musa Sikana has set the 19th April 2021 to proceed with the case filed against the head of CID, Grace Akulo, by the former presidential candidate, Lieutenant General Henry Tumukunde. In this case, Lieutenant General Henry Tumukunde wants this court to grant him permission to take some of the rising issues in this matter to the Constitutional Court for the constitutional interpretation. We have the story.
During the proceedings, my client intended, or actually withdrew, his cause against the Attorney General, but the judge decided that he should continue and deliver a ruling as Attorney General, being first respondent. We also want to hear that from the Constitutional Court. Can someone be forced to maintain a cause against another person?
Some of these issues which await constitutional interpretation include whether it is lawful for the Attorney General to represent the Criminal Investigations Department boss Grace Akulo in court when sued personally, court's refusal to allow Tumukunde to withdraw the case against the Attorney General, and lastly, whether it was illegal for Tumukunde to meet with veterans to discuss issues concerning politics. Although the Attorney General had filed a response in this application, he did not serve Tumukunde's legal team, and thus Justice Musa Sekana ordered them to serve the applicant's legal team before the closure of today.
We filed that application asking this court to refer those questions to the Constitutional Court for interpretation. We filed our application, they replied, we filed our written submissions, they filed their written submissions in reply, but they did not serve us. So the court has directed them to serve us, then we shall also rejoin, and after that come back on 19th. For directions on when the ruling can be done.
In the main suit before Justice Musa Sekana, Lieutenant General Henry Tumukunde wants court to block all the summons issued against him by the CID boss Grace Akulo, compelling him to appear at the CID headquarters to make a statement or face arrest.
In the matter of Lieutenant General Henry Tumukunde against Attorney General and the police CID boss Grace Akulo, we came to this court to block her summons against the general. And also the intended arrest of the general on allegations that the general was having political discussions with veterans, the UPDF veterans. And for us, we thought that was not constitutional, that is a violation on his rights, freedom of expression, freedom of association, and other rights that were being violated. So during the proceedings, we realized that the Attorney General was representing Grace Akulo, who we had sued personally. And so we believe that is a question that needs to be determined by the Constitutional Court.
Although this case seems to be overtaken by events since Lieutenant General Henry Tumukunde was summoned to appear at the CID headquarters in Chibuli during elections, Counsel Wameri Anthony insists that this isn't an issue to their client.
The court record shows that Grace Akulo is maintaining the summons. She insists the general should appear, so the matter is still alive and it should be dealt with by the court. Okay. If the court doesn't refer it to the Constitutional Court, it has to make a finding on whether it was lawful and legal for Grace Akulo to summon the general on issues that she has not clarified, especially on offences that are not either prescribed in the law or even mentioned in the summons.
Lieutenant General Henry Tumukunde was present in court, although he declined to talk on camera over the issues in this case. Tumukunde's trouble began when he allegedly met with veterans to discuss issues concerning politics when he contested in the presidential race. This prompted the CID boss, Grace Akulo, to summon him to appear at the CID headquarters in Chibuli to make a statement over this issue or else be arrested, which Tumukunde declined to and ran to the courts of law. This story was compiled by Annette Nakaibale for the news in Kampala.